Hi, I'm Rami Tamimi. In this video, I'm going to show you how to build a surface on AutoCAD Civil 3D. There are three different things that we're going to go over for building surfaces. Number one, creating point groups from our existing points in Civil 3D. Number two, manually drawing in the break lines between points that we can add into our surface. And number three, talking about the different styles and representations that your surface can have, whether you want to add in contours or tin lines. We'll go over all of that in this video. To start, we're going to be importing data from our topographic survey. If you don't know how to import your data, I've made a video describing how to do that and how to change the point style so you have a customized label and symbol for every point. Click on the eye in the corner to watch that video and then come back here and I'll show you how to use those points to create a surface. As you can see here, I brought in all the points from the field. And just to make sure that I'm in the right spot, I'm gonna go into the geolocation tab and turn on the aerial map. And it looks like, yeah, they're coming in where they should be. So we're gonna start out by creating point groups of all the points that are in the project. To do this, you're gonna go into the Prospector tab, Point Groups, right click, and select New. And now you're gonna type in your first point group, which for me, I'm gonna start with buildings. I'm gonna go to Include. I'm gonna check with Raw Description Matching. And for buildings, I use the code BLDG, so I will type in BLDG, and it's always a good practice to put an asterisk afterwards. Remember, asterisk means that there might be something after the raw description code, so to also include those points, let's say there's a number after it, it'll still include it. Click OK. And now if I were to check in on our point group, we can see all of these points that have raw descriptions of BLDG are in this point group. I'll repeat the process and I'll add in another point group. Let's do concrete shots, include C asterisk. Okay, we'll go again. Let's do the back of curb and we'll go to include raw description BC. And I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward here. I've added all of the point groups for my project. The reason we're creating point groups is we want to differentiate different groups for different points. This will make it easier to distinguish points that have good elevations and points that have bad elevations. We don't want to be including points that have bad elevations into our surface because it'll ruin our surface. I'll show you what happens when we add all of the points in, especially the ones that have bad elevations, and how it can ruin our surface. After you've created all of your point groups, the next step is going to be to create break lines between the points. Now, I briefly went over this in a previous video about line work and how to create different types of lines for your project. So to start drawing break lines, what you're gonna need to do is go into the layers and select the layer that you wanna work with. Let's start with back of curb. Now I'm gonna move into the back of curbs. Now I'm gonna use this imagery in the background just to make sure I'm in the ballpark, I'm drawing in the right place. So I'm gonna type in the command 3D poly. It's important to make sure that you're snapping to your points. To do this, you're just gonna select the node option under the O snap, that's considered object snap. You can also press F3 on your keyboard, and F3 will trigger it on and off. So mine is on. I'm gonna go to this point, and I'm gonna select all of the points where there is a back of curb. As you can see, I've got the back of curb in. I'm gonna keep working around this project. All right, now that I've finished the back of curbs, I'm gonna move into buildings. So we'll draw in all the building lines. Okay, and then another one. All right, got all the buildings in. Next layer, center line. It's as simple as just picking the points. Concrete. Now I want to show you an example of drawing in lines but not wanting them to be included in the surface. Here we're missing a line for the driveway, and I really wish we had picked up this line in the field. For this line, I don't want to use a 3D polyline. I may want to just use a regular polyline. So I'm going to just do PL and just draw in this polyline. The reason we don't want to use a 3D polyline is because we don't know the elevation of this point right here. We can't guess what the elevation is because it was never shot in. So the only thing that we can do is visually represent the location of this driveway. Using a 2D polyline or just a regular polyline, we'll do that just fine. And again, I'm gonna do the same thing here. I'm just gonna draw in using a regular polyline these sidewalks and driveways. So these lines are polylines, but then over here where I do have points, they are 3D polylines with elevations. And I'm just gonna go ahead and keep drawing in these 3D polylines. And I think with that, I've now drawn in all of the 3D polylines for our project. All right, now that we've added all the lines and brake lines for our project, the last thing to do is to create the surface. To do this, you're gonna start out by going into the Prospector tab, and where it says Surface, you're gonna right click and select Create Surface. You wanna make sure that you have a tin surface, and let's go ahead and create a layer for our surface. I'm gonna click New, and I'm gonna name this layer Surface. And click OK, make sure that that's selected. OK, OK. Then you're gonna name your surface, topo surface. Okay, and now we have our topo surface. The next thing we need to do is add information to our surface. So you're gonna open up topo surface, you're gonna then open up definitions, and now you have all these options that you can add to your surface. We're gonna start with point groups. Go ahead and click add, and these are all the point groups that we created earlier on. I'm gonna select the ones that are applicable for my project. So these are the ones that I want. I'm gonna hit OK. And now I have all the point groups in the surface. Next, we're gonna need to add the brake lines to our project. The easiest way to do this is to select a few of the lines that you wanna add. So I wanna add the back of curb, the gutter, the concrete sidewalk, and the center line of the road. I'm gonna right click and select similar. What select similar does is it selects the same exact type of line on the same type of layer. So if you have a different type of line, it will not select it. Or if you have a different type of layer, it will not select that either. Notice how the 3D polylines from the buildings were not selected, nor were the 2D polylines of the concrete selected. That's because I don't want them to be a part of our surface. Once you've got those lines selected, you're gonna go to brake lines, click add. For your description, you could just call this brake lines. Doesn't really matter what you write there, and then hit OK. And now there are brake lines in our surface. Now to see the surface, you need to go into the style editor and turn on the display of different features of the surface. To do this, you're gonna right click on topo surface and select edit surface style. I like to turn on the points, the triangles, the border, the major and the minor contours. You can select what kind of color you want and hit OK. And now our surface is present and we can see it. This like cyan and blue color are the contour lines. The white triangles is the tin line. Tin stands for triangular irregular network because we're creating a network of triangles using the points for our surface. And the magenta colored points are the points that are included inside of our surface. Notice how all of these points that are in the surface are magenta, but the building points are not. I'll explain why you don't want to add all of the points to the surface. Now, looking at the surface, there's definitely some cleanup work that needs to happen. The big and obvious one is this point right here, which seems to be creating a giant hole in our surface. To give you a better perspective, allow me to open the object viewer. Take a look at this now. You can see a giant hole is being created for our surface. That's because this point's elevation is incorrect. So, to fix this, you don't want to just delete this point. The reason you don't want to just delete this point is because the horizontal coordinates of the point might be fine. You just don't want to include it in your surface. If you select the surface, a new ribbon will pop up called the Tin Surface menu. If you go over to Modify, Edit Surface, and Delete Point, you can then delete points out of your surface. So I'm going to select this point, and now that point is gone and the surface is a lot cleaner. Another thing you might notice is that the tin lines are going all over the place, connecting in areas that they really shouldn't be connecting, like between these two sidewalks. To fix this, you're going to need to delete the tin lines. Select the surface again, go under Edit Surface, and delete line. Now you can delete these tin lines out of the surface. So anytime you see a large jump between points, you're going to want to clean that up. That's not supposed to be happening. So that looks fine here. All these points look okay. Usually this is going to happen around the borders. So again, right here, like that's bad. You don't want that. I'm going to delete this. Generally, this looks okay now. Yeah, I can live with this. Now you may notice that the contours sometimes look really jagged and just very pointy and not very clean. To fix this, you're going to right click on Edit Surface Styles, and under the Contour tab, you're going to come to contour smoothing, go to true, and then I like to put this all the way at the max level. So now my contours will be smooth. In this menu, you can also change the contour intervals. If you like 1 foot contours, you can do 1 foot for minor, 5 foot for major. Maybe you want 2 foot contours with 10 foot at major. All depends on what your kind of style is. I'm gonna keep mine at one, hit okay. As you can see, now the contours look a lot smoother. Something else that looks really strange is how it's coming back and forth, when really this should just be a connected line. What you can do to fix this is swap the edges of these tin lines. Select the tin, go to Edit Surface, and Swap Edge. Now you can click on some of these lines and it will clean up the contours so they look a little more presentable. I'm just gonna go through here and I don't like how this is coming out. So yeah, that looks more like how it should be, like this. Okay, that looks better. Come up here, take a look. We can clean this up a little bit. Okay, that looks good. Okay, and I think that looks to be pretty good. I like that more. Now, the reason why I made you categorize your points into point groups and not just add them all at once was your surface was gonna need a lot more cleanup to do. Let me show you what it would have looked like if you just add all the points at once. If we just go to point groups, add, and I just select all points, you're gonna see a crazy network of contour lines that are coming in at the wrong area. The border is extended really far out and it just doesn't look bright. It creates a lot more work for you to do. Whereas if you just categorize your points into point groups, you save a lot more time in cleaning up. Look, I cleaned this up in a couple of minutes. Whereas if we did it like this, it would probably take over an hour. Organizing your work and keeping your points categorized properly will save you so much time in cleanup work. Once you're satisfied with how your surface looks, you can then select the surface and turn off some of these layers. I'm gonna turn off the points, the triangles, and the borders. So I'm only gonna leave the contour lines. And I'm gonna go ahead and add some labels to my contours. So I'm gonna go to the Annotate tab. I'm gonna click on Add Labels. The feature is a surface. The label type is a contour single. Click OK, Add. And then I can go in here and just click on random spots, add in contours. I can then change how these contours look, but for now I'm just gonna add in a bunch of labels to my contours in my drawing. Okay, great. And that's it. That is how you can create a surface using your line work and your points in AutoCAD Civil 3D. And with that, I will see you guys next time.